FBI profiling, 35% more money. Regular hours, not as unpredictable as these.
How are you gonna convince me to leave Detroit?
The National Guard and a drink.
Alex Cross.
Got ourselves the Four Roses. Hey, Alex.
You're gonna want to prepare yourself for this one. Woman was tortured to death.
Hola, ¿qué tal, amigos de Entermedia? ¿Cómo están? Yo soy Luis G. Hey, la verdad estoy muy contento porque estoy aquí con el señor Matthew Fox. Matthew, thank you very much for the interview.
Yes, thank you.
Alex Cross, I was checking another interviews with you, and for you, what is the main challenge to create your character?
Well, I mean, for me personally, the main challenge was to sort of find out for myself what motivates him. What it is that he's trying to accomplish or prove, and to himself or to the world. And but there were many challenges with this guy. I mean, you know, I had this crazy idea that he would look the way that he looks in the movie. So, you know, I had 6 months of dieting and exercising and losing a lot of weight because I really felt that he would look that way. I felt like he would look that way because the ideas that are in him require so much energy to support and to rationalize that it would be sort of eating away at his own physique. And and then there was the challenges of the actual shooting of the film and all the different things that he was really good at, the cage fighting, the weapons training, and the things that, you know, I had to sort of hopefully make look legit and like an extension of him. It was the whole thing was, you know, a lot of challenges.
Had to be at least two or three guys to pull this off.
No, this is one guy.
I'm fascinated by pain.
He's ex-military, special forces, judging by his tactics. Trying to make somebody hurt. Wants somebody to pay. Wants the world to suffer.
I was checking other also interviews, and you says that you don't check the books for your character. You check the script and you make your character. But yeah. Do you check another character? I don't know, maybe like Hannibal Lecter, this thing that Picasso is a serial killer.
No, I mean, I just, you know, I just don't think that. That roles are that general, you know, like I wouldn't say like, well, because Picasso's a serial killer, I'm gonna go look at other serial killers. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, I do think that, you know, I really thought that he's kind of like a role that only exists in the movies. And so I really didn't feel like obligated to any, you know, like sort of real life examples of serial killers like Jeffrey Dahmer or Ted Bundy. And I didn't feel obligated to James Patterson's sort of book. I mean, you know, I felt like it was this kind of wide open canvas, and I really didn't know where I was going to take this guy for some time. I mean, I had an image of what he would look like and maybe the way that he would carry himself, but I wanted to have the freedom to sort of like go down a bunch of different roads and see where it took me.
This guy, he's checking off the list. He's focused, he's got a clear path.
Dr. Cross, are you there?
Are you having fun?
Inflicting pain is a crucial part of my true calling.
You are sick and twisted.
Dr. Cross, you're taking this personally. By the way, you have a very pretty wife. She looks stunning.
He won't stop. I've seen his face. I've heard his voice. I will meet his soul at the gates of hell before I let him take a person that I love from me.
No! There is not one scenario that you have thought of that he has not already figured out.
I'm going to enjoy this.
We've got to get inside his head. Where would he be?
He's already in the building. Move. Let me see your hands.
are beginning a new year, and what is the next for Matthew Fox?
I don't know what the next film is. I'm not sure. I'm going to be, you know, reading things and sort of taking a look around. I mean, I know that, you know, I have another film coming out in March, Emperor, with Tommy Lee Jones, and then I have World War Z coming out in June. If I don't find something to work on, a new film, then most of my first half of the year will be spent sort of starting, you know, going out and promoting the films when they come out, and the rest of the time will be spent doing fun things with my family and friends. I would be really happy if I didn't find anything to work on until sort of the second half of the year, you know, and I'm really enjoying my home right now and just doing things there that I love, and so I don't know, we'll see. I don't really know what the next thing will be until I read that script and get really excited about it and start working on it.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
Come on now. You can do better than that.